Hello YouTube friends and family, this is Vanessa. I actually recorded this video this morning while getting ready for work, and I paused the video because my battery was running low, went to plug it in and never turned the video back on. So I did my whole video in front of the camera and it wasn't even recording. So I'm gonna try and do that for you now. I've come home from work, I've cleaned all my makeup off, and I'm gonna try and recreate the look that I made this morning. And of course, I know it's not going to come out exactly as it did this morning, but I'm going to try. So, I'm going to use, because I was wearing purple today, I'm going to use the Kat Von D Crystalis palette. I really like Kat Von D's eyeshadows. So, I'm just going to go ahead and get started. I've primed my face, primed my eyes, and I'm just going to go ahead and get started. And I cleaned most of the brushes that I use for this look, and so the brushes that I would normally use are wet right now, so again, I hope I can recreate the look the way I did it this morning. So let's get started. I'm gonna start out with this color right here, and it's like a light, very light lavenderish color with shimmer in it. I'm going to put that on the lower half of the lid. I've got a mirror over here to my left, so I'm going to be looking over here to the left. When I first started out this look this morning, I wasn't happy with how it started out with this very, very sheer color on the lower half of the lid, but when I finished it, I was happy with it, so I like the way that it turned out, so I'm going to do the same thing again. Although it looks like this color that's on the bottom half is just way too sheer. I'm going to try to speed portions of this video up if I can, so that I don't bore you all to death with the quiet moments like this. Okay, so that's that. And then I'm going to go above the crease with this color here. It's a little deeper purpley color with micro glitter. And I'm going to go on the crease and above, and just above it. I have hooded eyelids, so I really have to take the color up for you to be able to see it. Otherwise, it'll just be hidden in my lid. And I'm not going all the way in because I'm going to put another color there, and I'm not going all the way out because I'm going to put another color at the outer area. Okay, and then with this what do you call it, angled brush, I'm going to use the darkest purple here. And try to concentrate that at the outer lower lash line and outer V area. And try not to take away all of my other color too much. But I want this to show up. I want it to overlap with the other color some, but not too much. Okay. Let's try to do this here. Oh, somebody's periscoping. Then wherever I mess up, and go too far out. When I put on my foundation, I can clean that portion up. And then I'm just going to use this color here and a little bit of this up at my brow bone. Just tap that in. Then I'm just going to brush off some of that color. It's very light, and try to blend these colors here without really adding any more product, but just blend them. It looks like on this eye here, I've taken away the majority of my second color, so I'm going to go in and just add a little bit more. Okay, and go back and grab my blending brush. Going to clean that off again so I can use it again. My angled brush. I didn't put any more product. I was hoping there'd still be some on there that I could blend inward. Seemed like I lost a little bit of my definition. Okay, that's that. And then I'm going to use this Lorac felt tip liner. Move my mirror closer. Since I'm not very good at drawing a straight line, I try to get close to the lash line and just stamp my line on and then just connect them. Or they're not connected. And I stamp a line. And see, I made that one too thick. But we're going to try and rescue that. Okay. Normally, the more I try to fix it, the more I mess it up. So I'm going to leave it alone. intensify that a little bit more. My lightest color. And then we're going to go for some mascara. I'm using The Last Domination by Bare Minerals. To get my lashes as dark as I can. So I have very short lashes. I think that's the best I can do with the lashes. And then that's not working out so well. I have a nicer color that would show up. There. But it's not in this palette, and I'm trying to just stick with this palette. There, the brighter purple showing up a little bit more. Took my black away. It's a little better. So there are my eyes. Now I'm going to go with the Dirty Beauty Blender, my L'Oreal Infallible Makeup Extender Spray, and just wet my Beauty Blender. Kind of learning my lesson, learning how to use it, I should say. Learning my lesson with this. I had it too wet this morning and made a huge mess. I am using the Lancome Tint Idol, or Idol, and I think I'm 520. I can't even read this thing. Yeah, there it goes. 520 suede. 520 suede warm. I don't know if any of you can see that. Can you see that? I think it says 520 suede. And a W. I'm going to put a pump of that on one side of my face and work one side at a time. It may look like this color is too light right now, but it oxidizes. I put 540 on in Sephora. Loved it. Wore it to work that day, and at the end of the day, I put it on at Sephora and loved it. Got a sample of it. Wore it to work the next day, and my face looked like mud because it oxidizes darker, as this will. So, like I said, this may look like it's a little bit too light right now, but it's Really not. Another spray for the other side. One thing, I'm still learning how to use this beauty blender. I feel like I use more foundation using the beauty blender than I do when I use my stippling brush. But that's what I'm doing, practicing and learning. I have better luck with the way it goes on, the way my foundation goes on, without having my beauty blender very wet. Maybe I had it too wet, but what is with these? I had one over here last week, and now I've got another lump there. Looks like I've got a bag, but that's a bump. I wonder if it's this, what is it? This stuff right here. LA Girl Pro Concealer, because that's the only thing I put right there. And I got a bump last week. Because I don't really use it all the time. I'm going to have to, that was not here this morning. But I used this stuff this morning. Blend good, right? So we don't look we have a mask on. Okay. And then my look is almost complete, really. I'm going to use some of this MAC Mineralize Skin Finish, and I have Dark Deepest. Looks like that. I just kind of dab that on my face. Then, for a little bit of a under eye highlight, I have this Park Avenue Princess. It's actually a bronzer, waterproof bronzer, but because of the color of it, on me it works as a good highlight if you want to put just a little bit of brightness here. But two, I have to be careful because I have oily skin and it makes it look like I've got an oily sheen. Like just now I put too much. Looks like I've got a little sheen of oil on my face. Because you put it right in your T-zone area. And then I have a little bit of blush, which I can't find right now. I had it. There it is. Bought a new blush. Bought a MAC blush, but I'm not sure if I want to keep it. I'm not going to use it yet. I'm just using this Kat Von D blush, and I don't know if it's the right color for me, but it's called Por Vida. But I just try to dab it on lightly. So then that way I don't look like a clown too much. And that's that. Except for eyebrows. One day I sprayed so much of this on my face that it wet my shadow, and my shadow all moved and came like off. Messed up my whole eyeshadow look. Okay. I'm gonna take this and dust it over my face again. Do you see what I mean? It made it look like I'm real shiny in through there. What do you want, Keys?
Yes.
Here, Keys. Say hi on the camera. That's my daughter, Natalia, everybody. You going home?
Yep.
She's leaving me. Probably because I'm in here doing a video and not out there talking to her. She says it's time to go. But anyway, everyone, I was trying to take some of that shine down. I think I did okay with that. And lastly, I need to do lips and I need to do some eyebrows. I'm going to line my lips. This MAC Night Moth. And then, on the outer, right over the Night Moth, basically, this is MAC Pure Heroin. And then on the inner, Heroin. Then I'm going to try to do some eyebrows here. Not very good at it, so don't judge me. Like I said, this is all practice for me. I'm not a professional. I'm just doing my makeup the best that I know how. I know they're not the same, but y'all know that eyebrows are sisters, not twins. Try and get them the best I can. And that is it. I think my camera says it's only got 3 minutes of battery left. That's it for my look. Let me know what y'all think. And thanks for watching. Bye.